Toys and comics are a big part of the reason fans flock to the Motor City Comic Con, but there's also other attractions as well. Where else can you rub elbows with some of the biggest stars of sci-fi movies and television? TV's Batgirl, Yvonne Craig, was on hand to greet fans and sign autographs, as was James Hawn, who has appeared in such movies as Blade Runner, Wayne's World 2, and Big Trouble in Little China. His TV credits include The X-Files, Friends, and the now-famous Chinese restaurant episode of Seinfeld. Also making appearances were Richard Hatch, best known as Apollo from TV's Battlestar Galactica, and Anne Lockhart, daughter of June Lockhart and another star of Battlestar Galactica. Fans of the Star Wars movies must have been excited to find out that four, count them, four actors from the famous trilogy were present at the Motor City Comic Con. Carolyn Blakiston may have only had a little bit of screen time in Return of the Jedi, but she will always be remembered as Mon Mothma, leader of the Rebel Alliance to Star Wars fans.
Well, you know, when I did my part, which is Mon Mothma in The Return of the Jedi, I had one speech, one entrance, one short scene, and I was on the screen for 26 and a half seconds. That's all. So it was quite a strange feeling to discover 20 years later or 14 years later that I'm part of an enormous moving staircase going towards the future. You know, these films where it's like an accumulative excitement that's come from the films. And it's absolutely thrilling. I wouldn't miss it for anything in the world. And I'll tell you why if you've got time for me to tell you. I think these films are stories, great, great modern myths about good and evil. And though what they are as well is just entertainment, funny, very funny, that's one of the reasons they're so successful, I think. We see different bits of human beings all shown, all in different creatures. And we know that good is going to win, has to win. So we're there rooting, like for the fact for the old fairy tales that we heard when we were kids. That's all it is. It's just a modern fairy tale. And it's really thrilling to be part of it.
She talked about what it was like to be surrounded by the strange menagerie of creatures on the set.
I never did anything like that before. I mean, I've done it in the theater where you do maybe a children's pantomime or Toad of Hall where everybody's an animal. In fact, I've been animals in plays, often myself. No, it was. But you know, we did it in great heat in the studio, which was rather like this conference center here, great film studio. And there were many, many people there. There were hundreds of extras. There was the crew of the film, making the film of the film and all that. And some of the actors under the heads, the helmets, got so hot that between takes, they used to take them off and blow a hairdryer doing cool air up through the hole so that the actors, they didn't have time to take them off, just give them a quick shot of cold air from the cold hairdryer so that they could cool down a bit for the next shot.
Practically every character that has appeared in the Star Wars trilogy has been reproduced in plastic as an action figure, except for Mon Mothma, that is, until now.
You know, I've done this, this is about my fourth convention in America, and from the very first they all said, where's the action figure? I said, I'm just an actress, please don't ask me. But I believe she's coming soon, and I believe she's going to be in the card game as well. So we'll have more opportunities for signing and more interesting things for people. See, I only had such a tiny bit to do. You can only have a certain number of photographs from one small scene.
Phil Brown only appeared in the first Star Wars movie, A New Hope. He portrayed Luke Skywalker's uncle, Uncle Owen. Brown's hopes of appearing in any sequel went up in smoke when Luke discovered his aunt and uncle had been killed by stormtroopers.
As far as I was concerned, it was just another job, and for me, a rather small job, because I'd played much larger roles in other things, in the theater in London, and in New York, and in Hollywood, and so forth, so it was just a nice job. I liked it, but it was just a job.
Brown told us he's enjoying the recognition from fans for a role he performed more than 20 years ago.
Well, sure, of course I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying being here and signing autographs and so forth. it's just something you couldn't have predicted. Nobody could, not even George could have predicted this, that it was going to be this popular. And as a number of people have said, the reason it's so popular is that it's about good and evil, as Westerns used to be in the old days, good and evil. The good boys win, the bad boys get punished. So that's what this is about too. And it's kind of universal. We like to think that we're on the side of the goodies and that the goodies will win.
In Return of the Jedi, the cute little teddy bears known as Ewoks help the rebels secure a victory against the evil empire. Our introduction to that fictional race was Wicket, the Ewok that befriended Princess Leia. Wicket was played by actor Warwick Davis.
Okay, well, I was 12 years old when I did Return of the Jedi, so I was already a big fan of Star Wars and Empire at that time. So to be involved with one of those movies was a great thrill. And yeah, I was well aware of the kind of the scale of that movie, but just enjoyed it immensely. And now I look back, and all these years on, we're still talking about it. And so I feel very honored to have been part of that series.
Davis has appeared in other films sans teddy bear costume, such as Willow. But fans line up at events like these to meet the man behind the mask of Wicket.
It's fantastic, as I said, to be still talking about this movie 16 years on. That's the only way you could do it. And my nephew back in England, he's like 11 years old, and he's now become a fan of the movies because of the special edition. So this whole new generation of Star Wars fans has emerged now, and they're all anticipating the release of the prequel next year.
Davis is one of the few actors invited back to portray a character in the new trilogy of Star Wars movies. The movies are set to take place before the events in Star Wars. Davis was tight-lipped about revealing any secrets.
I can't really tell you a lot about my characters or anything because it's all top secret, and I've signed an agreement that I won't speak about it, but I can give an exclusive to say that my character is 3'6" tall.
I've seen some photos in the fan mansions. To see R2-D2 again and things like that.
Oh, yeah.
Conjuring up old memories.
Oh, it was amazing. When I walked onto the set the first day and there was R2 stood there and the rest of the things that you really recognize from Star Wars, I was just... It was amazing. It was amazing. Because I'm a fan of the movies, so I feel that I've got this sort of extra inside knowledge of the movie. You know, it's wonderful.
And finally, there's one character who, despite just a little bit of screen time, has an enormous fan following. The bounty hunter Boba Fett delivered Han Solo and friends to Darth Vader in The Empire Strikes Back, then delivered a frozen Han Solo to the villainous Jabba the Hutt in Return of the Jedi. How this thorn in the hero's side became so popular with fans remains a mystery, but the actor who portrayed him, Jeremy Bullock, did his best to explain the phenomenon.
One of the reasons, I think, is certainly the costume is number one. It's a wonderful costume. Also, the mystery about him. And also, he's a bit of a Pied Piper, really. You know, they follow the tune. I mean, kids come up to you and go, wow, you're Boba. They relate to him. He's evil, but he's not. He's also a nice guy somewhere, I think. So they can relate to that. You know, it's terrible if all kids said, look at this evil person. It's pretend violence with Boba Fett. It's not real, but kids relate to him. And I'm amazed by the popularity. I still get 100 letters a week. You know, even with the re-release out, it's been gone a year. And I reply to everybody, and luckily I'm up to date. Being at this convention, I've brought a lot of stuff with me, and I've been writing, and it's gone off. I'm amazed, really.
Bullock portrayed Boba Fett in all scenes but one. In this scene, Fett is portrayed by the actor who also played Luke's snowspeeder gunner, Dak.
Lord Vader, you may take Captain Solo to Jabba the Hutt after I have Skywalker.
He's no good to me dead.
He will not be permanently damaged.
Fett's five lines were dubbed in by yet another actor. Bullock recalled how he got the role.
Well, it's funny because Star Wars obviously was already out when I joined it in Empire Strikes Back. As with every job, your agent calls you, and as an actor you always hope he's going to call you. And he said, they want to see you on Monday for this Star Wars 2, he called it. I said, Star Wars 2? I said, well, sequels never work. So I said, oh, well, we'll go up for it. And they wanted to see a group of actors to play these bounty hunters, what I thought was just one scene. But the interview was so nice. It's one of the nicest interviews I've had, because normally you have to do loads of talking and they say, yeah, that's not bad, but we'll do a screen test. Here, George Lucas, Irving Kirshner, Gary Kurtz talked to me as I put the outfit on. And at the end of this, when I finally got everything on and walked around with a gun, they said, yeah, that looks pretty cool. Okay, well, would you like to play the part of this bounty hunter? His name is Boba Fett. I said, well, yes, I mean, I love it. He said, well, it's only 3 weeks' work, Jeremy, you know. And, well, welcome aboard. It was that simple, and that's how lucky one is, you know, really. I mean, it's just no hard work at all involved in the interview. It's wonderful.
If you look closely, Bullock also appears in Empire without a mask. Here he plays an Imperial officer taking the rebels to Darth Vader's ship. Again, despite limited screen time, Boba Fett has also become one of the most marketable images from the trilogy, rivaling Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader in popularity. Fett's image has been captured as action figures, costumes, posters, t-shirts, and even coffee mugs.
I mean, the character Boba Fett has probably got more merchandise out about him than anyone, because people want to see, and I get stuff sent to me, sketches that people have done from three-year-olds, and I have a room at home, my wife's going crazy. It's like a shrine to Boba Fett.
Boba Fett!